Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Team Foundation Server. The Team Foundation Server Toolkit is a high-performance data integration solution that works for Team Foundation Server, utilizing Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services capabilities. Our Team Foundation Server Toolkit supports SSIS 2012 or above. In today's demo, we will show you our software running in a SQL Server 2012 environment. If you are using a different SQL Server version, the interface might be slightly different. To get started, let's create a simple SSIS project. This tutorial assumes that you already have the SSIS bits installed. Otherwise, you will not see the SSIS project type here. In the Business Intelligence template, select the Integration Services project and give your project a name. Press OK to create the solution. SSIS is a platform that can be used to implement data migration and integration using its drag-and-drop capabilities. To begin the SSIS implementation using our toolkit, we will create a connection to the Team Foundation server. To do so, right-click in the Connection Manager area and select New Connection. Then we will choose Team Foundation option from the list and select Add. The authentication type option allows you to specify the deployment type of your Team Foundation server and what authentication is used. There are two options available: Active Directory on-premise and Visual Studio Team Services by alternate credentials. In our example today, we will use the Visual Studio Team Services by alternate credentials option. The Service URL field lets you specify the service URL of the Team Foundation server you will connect to. If you have chosen the Active Directory on-premise option as your authentication type, you can enable the Use Integrated Authentication option. Otherwise, you can provide separate login credentials, starting with your username and password in the next section. Note that the password option allows you to specify the personal access token for the above user in order to be able to connect to Team Foundation server. The domain option is used to specify the Active Directory domain of the Team Foundation server user account. This option is only available if you have chosen Active Directory on-premise as the authentication type earlier. The timeout option allows you to specify the maximum number of seconds that this connection manager will wait while trying to establish a connection with Team Foundation server. This is defaulted to 120 seconds. Let's head to the Advanced Settings tab. There is an option for retry and intermittent errors. This option is intended to help recover from possible intermittent outages or disruption of service, so that the integration does not have to be stopped due to temporary networking issues. We have designed this option so it should only retry when it's deemed to be safe to do so, but there may be exceptions. We also have proxy server connection settings, which you can enter if you're behind a proxy server. Before we hit OK, we should test the connection to make sure our information is correct and we can connect successfully. Please note that the connection manager that we just created is a package-level connection manager. You can create project-level connection managers if you right-click the Connection Managers node within the Solution Explorer. After creating the Team Foundation Connection Manager, you can start to create data flow tasks to facilitate data integration. Within your data flow task, we offer two data flow components that would help you to implement integration solutions for Team Foundation Server. The first component that we are discussing is the Team Foundation Source component, which is what you use to read or retrieve data from Team Foundation Server. Later on in this demo, we will show you the Team Foundation Destination component, which is what you may use to write data into Team Foundation Server. In order to use these two components, you would want to make sure they are available in the SSIS toolbox. To use the Team Foundation source component, we can simply drag this component to the design surface of the data flow task. Double-click to open its editor form. Let's select a Team Foundation connection manager. The source type option allows you to specify which type of TFS query you want to use. There are two options available: predefined query and custom query. When Custom Query is selected, you can specify which columns you want to retrieve from Team Foundation Server. For more information on how to build your TFS queries, please refer to the link provided for TFS documentation within our online help manual page. In our example today, we will select predefined query as our source type. The project option allows you to specify which TFS project is used. The output time zone option specifies how daytime values are retrieved. There are two options available, UTC and adjust to local system time zone. Since we have selected predefined query as our source type, the query option is available to us. The drop-down menu will show you a list of available TFS queries. Work item detail types option allows you to specify whether to retrieve attachments and/or comments. Once this function is enabled, additional outputs will become available to use for the downstream pipeline components. Clicking the Refresh Component button will retrieve the latest metadata from Team Foundation Server and update each field. Let's navigate to the Columns page where we can see all available columns from the query we have selected. Here you will notice that by default, all the Team Foundation Server fields are selected. This may not be the best practice. You should only select the fields that you need to use in the downstream pipeline components. Since we are also retrieving attachments and comments, we can view a list of the fields from these additional outputs. Click OK to finish configuring the source component. For this demonstration, we're going to add dummy data readers for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to destination components. We can now execute this data flow task. Next, we will create a data flow task to demonstrate the Team Foundation destination component. As mentioned before, the Team Foundation destination component is used to write data to your Team Foundation server instance. To demonstrate this capability, we will use the data spawner as a source component in order to generate some sample data to work with. The data spawner component is a part of the SSIS Productivity Pack offering, which is a collection of premium SSIS components to enable greater developer productivity. Now let's drag the Team Foundation destination component and connect to the upstream data flow component. Double-click to open its editor form. On the general page, we must first select the Team Foundation Connection Manager. There are four actions available: create, update, delete, and upsert. In our example today, we will select the create action. Next, we can select a target project to specify which target project to write the data. The drop-down list will retrieve a list of all available TFS projects for the selected connection. Destination Entity option lists all available work item types for the target project we've specified. Now we can navigate to the Columns page, where we map the columns from the upstream components to the Team Foundation Server destination fields. As you can see, there has been an automatic mapping based on the name match. The last page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is Fail on Error, where the entire data flow will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the Redirect Rows to Error Output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns for error code, error column, and error message. The Ignore Error option is generally not recommended, as the component will stay silent for any errors that happen. There is also the Enable Columns for Default Output section, which you can use to enable or disable the additional column in the destination component's default output. The Team Foundation Server ID option contains a newly created TFS Records ID field value. Press OK to finish configuring this destination component. We can now execute this data flow task. This concludes a demonstration of our SSIS Integration Toolkit for Team Foundation Server. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.